Hey guys, thanks for tuning to Making It Work. If you've been here before, welcome back. If you haven't been here before, I'm Jimmy. I appreciate you tuning in. This video is going to be about setting your ego aside when you're working in the shop as an auto repair mechanic. Let's get into it. One of the hardest things for mechanics is to put their ego aside and ask for help when they need help. It doesn't matter if it comes to borrowing tools. I have a video about borrowing tools, if you should damage them and things like that. But all that aside, if you need a tool that you don't have and you're one of the younger guys, one of the experienced guys will most likely lend you the tool, especially if you've built some kind of relationship with that person. And I'll show you how to use it and use it correctly, which is an invaluable lesson in itself. But sometimes, like when I was a younger mechanic, I didn't really appreciate some of those things. So it's something to really pay attention to. Who are the guys in the shop that are willing to work with you, teach you things, and things that you might not even realize at the time how big it is. When they're willing to lend you tools, show you how to use a tool, and get you over another hurdle on your way to becoming a better mechanic, that's like an invaluable experience that I wish I appreciated more when I was a kid. There wasn't any YouTube at the time to watch videos like this to hear from experienced mechanics. How that all is going to work in the long run for you. Basically, when you were younger, back in the day when I was learning, you basically hunt and peck your way through it like a chicken in the field looking for worms. You know, you kind of found a way to make things work, figured it out for yourself, lots of cuts and bruises, lots of mistakes, and you kind of did things. I started out as an apprentice and pumping gas and things like that, and little by little I became a mechanic. I was lucky because I was so interested in cars that I just loved it so much. I wasn't even considering the money. I wanted the money for gas and to go to the beach and to take girls out to dinner or whatever the case may be, go to a movie. But I wasn't going, I'm going to be a mechanic so I can make lots of money. I just loved cars. I wanted to fix cars. But anyway, that experience that I got, I mean, that's just invaluable. Looking back now, I can remember the first time I wanted to rebuild a carburetor. And when I went to rebuild this carburetor, I didn't have any tools. I remember the mechanic that I worked with, who was my mentor, this guy named Steve. He came over with the tools and showed me how to adjust an electronic mixture control solenoid, the electric TPS that was on the carburetors and on those versions. I mean, it really was invaluable. At the time, I didn't, you know, I just like, well, we're getting the job done, and he was showing me how to do it. And you know, it wasn't until later on I realized how great that lesson I got was and the things that he showed me. Some people, if you had to figure that out yourself back then, it wasn't like you could watch a YouTube video and learn how to do it. People weren't giving their knowledge away. So you had to find somebody that was willing to share it with you. So it still happens today. Don't just assume you have to do all your learning on YouTube. Look towards the guys that you work with in the shop. Sometimes it's hard for us to put our egos aside and to look to other people that we work with and ask them for help. You know, whether it's lifting something heavy or some advice on an electrical item, putting a subframe back in a car, you know, whatever it might be. There's a ton of things that somebody in that shop you work with has experienced and been down that road. And, you know, put your ego aside and go ask for help. Especially if you might hurt yourself with something like the spring compressor or something like that, using a giant pry bar on a suspension arm and you're trying to get a ball joint back in. If that pry bar slips out of there, you know, ask one of the other mechanics, you know, do you have a bigger pry bar? Can you show me how to do this? Is there a trick? And usually they'll show you how they do it. And anyone who's got, you know, 10 years experience, 15 years experience or more is going to have a way. They can not only make your job easier, but keep you safer. So it's really important to communicate and not be afraid to reach out to other people that you work with. You'll know pretty soon when you're working in a shop, after just a few months, the people that you can talk to and ask for help and the people that you should leave alone. Because there are those people at almost every shop. There's going to be the guy that could be young or an old guy. It doesn't really matter. Could be a grumpy old bastard that you definitely don't want nothing to do with. Could be a grumpy young bastard you definitely don't want nothing to do with. So you got to pick your battles and make friends with the people that you think might help you and help each other out too. And there'll be times when, you know, a young buck's going to help an older guy do something he's not capable of doing anymore. Like, I'm starting to get the arthritis, you know, so a lot of abuse in the pickle juicers make it so that, you know, maybe I should have had more power tools when I was younger. Maybe it's just hereditary, and it would have happened either way. Who knows? Those older guys are going to need a hand from the younger guys, is my point. So just keep that in mind. So don't feel like you know less or you're lesser of a mechanic because you asked for help. To me, it actually makes you smarter. You know, it's like kind of like how doing the right thing is usually harder. Doing the wrong thing is easier, and doing the right thing is harder. It's kind of like if you're walking in a crowd and people are heading towards each other and nobody wants to yield and move out of the way because they feel like it makes them weak. But if you really boil that down, the people who don't want to move out of the way and yield are the weak ones. It takes strength to do the right thing and to yield and give somebody the passage and all that. And that goes into all kinds of things, holding doors, whatever it might be, driving aggressively in traffic. It could be anything. People tend to flip things around somehow, and I don't know how that happens, but if it feels easier and you just do what you want, that's weakness. The things that are hard, doing the right thing, putting your ego aside and asking for help, all those things are better. All those things are right, and all those things will make you a better mechanic, a better person, make you more productive, keep you safer. So there's every reason in the world to always do that. You know, if you're doing a diagnostics, you're learning electronics, and you got someone in the shop who's really good at it, you know, don't go over there when they're really busy and they're in the middle of something. You can tell they're frustrated. You got to pick your moment. And you know, if they're a little slow and you're looking at something maybe right on the edge of your spectrum, and you probably shouldn't have ended up with it, but somehow you did. They were really busy, so you got this ticket and you're halfway into it now and you can't really figure something out. Call them over and ask them, you know, if you have to. Say, hi, I'll buy you lunch, I'll buy you a soda, whatever it might be. Offer them something as a penance, you know. Don't be afraid to ask, though. I mean, I actually enjoy when someone is younger comes over and asks me. Not only because it's not like I need them to need my help, but it makes you feel like you've really, you know, lived your life, done your thing, gained your experience, whatever the case may be, and someone notices it, and they come over and they say, hey, man, you've probably done this before. Do you know what I can do to get this done? It really, I don't know, it's just a human thing, I guess, where, you know, you kind of feel like you've accomplished something because someone else notices the fact that you're capable. And at the same time, you know, those younger guys are going to know things that an older guy might not. Sometimes that younger guy, he's been to class on some things, and he's found out something about a TPMS system in a certain kind of vehicle that has a certain issue. Oh, you don't spend a lot of time on that Nissan. Those things have a lot of problems with the TPMS modules and stuff. Don't keep trying to program them sensors. Everything takes a unit. You know, it takes every person in that shop has their specialty, has their weakness, their strengths, whatever the case may be. So there's no harm in asking for help. Just put your ego aside and go do it. Save yourself the time. If you're working in a shop where no one's willing to help you, and you reach out to people for input and advice, maybe even a physical helping hand, which is a little bit more to ask, but it's something that you do and you're part of a team and you're trying to get things done. If you work in a shop where none of that happens, then it might be serious time to seriously consider another shop, maybe moving somewhere. You know, maybe even consider opening your own place. Once you gain more experience, work towards that. Work towards packing some money away and opening your own shop. But when you're young and if you're living with your parents still, especially, or if you got a couple of roommates all helping split the rent, you can pack some money away if you're smart with your money and maybe think about opening your own shop. If you're working in a shop where there's no cohesiveness, that's toxic. So you want to definitely try to avoid that. So we'll hope you guys got something out of this video. A little bit of just free thoughts. You know, I don't rehearse my videos and write scripts and things like that. Not only do I not have a lot of time for that, I also don't think it comes across as genuine. So if I rambled a little bit, I apologize for that. I wanted to let you guys know you're not alone and wondering about a lot of these things. So everybody's human, mechanic or not, even though some people might think mechanics aren't human, like a certain person I won't name that constantly degrades mechanics. So let's just all try to be better. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. You're awesome. Appreciate you.